with Beijing. You know, on our own soil, TikTok has been data mining markets.
Okay. Except, to put the belt on.
And you know, there's something even more important here. China used TikTok to hone their violence on American streets last year. And there's even more important issue. And that is China does not allow American apps in China. So why are we allowing Chinese apps in our country, especially when they're used to try to take down our government? Biden just does not want to deal with this issue. And that's the same thing this 90-day intelligence review on the origins of COVID. As Fred points out, look, he just doesn't want to deal with it. He wants to hide behind this and reduce delay.
Fred, does this remind you of when we saw the Obama administration put in the blinders just to get any, you know, just so they could have the Paris Climate Accords, just so they could have the Iran nuclear deal? They're willing
Howdy.
To look away from a lot of things here to lose these deals.
You know, that might be true, but I hate to say that I think this is driven by this administration's unbelievable hatred of President Trump. When it comes to the southern border or the Abraham Accords, anything Trump did, this administration wants to undo. There's no rational reason to reverse the sanctions on TikTok and these other Chinese apps. The only reason I think that Biden is doing this, and I agree with Gordon Chang, is that they do not want any Trump accomplishment to remain. They want to redo everything. They don't want Trump's name on anything that was accomplished in the last 4 years.
Gordon, that's a pretty dangerous way of operating, isn't it?
Yes, and especially, you know, we went through the Colonial Pipeline Act. Biden got on the microphone and said, look, I'm going to protect the electric grid. But on his first hours in office, Biden suspended President Trump's May 1st, 2020 executive order, which prohibited electric
utilities
grid operators from buying sabotage Chinese equipment. Biden has left the U.S. vulnerable to attack. He did that with the TikTok order yesterday. This is a disturbing trend, as Fred points out.
And, you know, when you hear that stuff, Fred, it sounds like they're opening up the door, you know, for China just to come right on in and have control of some of the most critical things in our lives.
I think all of our adversaries sense weakness here. They see a foreign policy that's frankly frivolous. It's focused on climate change. It's focused on reversing President Trump. It doesn't recognize
the
real
threats
to our security, primarily China, as
a
potential threat. And as Gordon and I talked about, China is not a competitor. As
right,
Trump,
let's get this door open.
He is an adversary. He might be an enemy. France and Germany are competitors. Competitors follow rules.
Right, let's see. What clue we get?
More and more people every single day. We'll see what comes of this meeting with President Biden and President Xi at the G7 summit. Gentlemen, great to see you so much. Gordon Chang, Fred Flight, we appreciate it.
What's this?
The backlash against critical race theory continues across the country. We'll talk about that with some people on the front lines. Coming up next.
Trump in 6 months, and Newsmax wants to know what you think. Should Facebook let Trump back on? You can vote in our poll, and it takes just a minute to vote. So just text us and register your vote now. We'll show your results on Newsmax TV, Newsmax.com, and with millions of Americans who want to know. Newsmax is real news for real people.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, and as you know, my passion is to help each and every one the best sleep of your life. That's why I created my new Giza Dreams bed sheets. I started by using the world's best cotton called Giza. It's only grown in a region between the Sahara Desert, the Mediterranean Sea, and the Nile River. It's ultra soft.
So that's what was behind it. I think I've seen this before. It's familiar. I don't know. Seriously, you need to watch where you swing that thing.
Use the promo code and I will give you 2 for $1 low price and free shipping. That's right, get 2 for $1 low price.
commodity on Earth, we need it to make solar power, cars, electronics, batteries, and because silver is an antiviral bactericide, demand is skyrocketing.
It hurts, but this is what we gotta do.
Stockpiles of silver are depleted, so the demand for silver is going up just as stockpiles of silver are going down. Silver still has the biggest run coming up.
Call your capital now for this free report.
Messed that up. Whoops.
Messed
that up.
Whoops.
I believe silver is on its way to a new record
level. I'll say it again. I love silver because it's important. And everybody can call it silver.
The report is free, but the information is priceless. So call now and ask how you can get up to $5,000 in bonus silver. Call 800-450-6767. 800-450-6767. 800-450-6767.
Hey,
Mom. If I could talk, what would I tell you? I'd tell
you about
our walks and jumping up to play. We do everything together.
Yeah. All right. Woo, they're free.
So I can stay right by your side.
Yourselves up.
Welcome back. The Ohio Attorney General has filed a lawsuit asking a court to declare Google a public utility. So what does this mean? This is the latest twist on the escalating legal efforts to rein in the company that runs the internet's largest search domain. AGB Yost is alleging that Google has been abusing its power in a way that is discriminatory and anti-competitive to Ohioans. He added that Google's use of its internet search steers Ohioans to the company's own.
Hold on, Sherrod. Person involved with the rustling. Music. Other people, and it's just plain wrong. Community service, son.
No, I don't give money to PACs.
Which one is that?
Police.
Stanford State, but, you know, a revenue portion off of that.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
When we see the effectiveness of this,
cool.
We see those advertisements, you know, they're obviously their data mining stuff works so well, it's obvious now that they are tracking everything we do, everywhere we go. You go to a certain part of the department store, and then you're getting there, see the advertisements for those products. It's amazing the studies are, you know, we are providing information that a lot of times we sign off on it.
I must say, that was very interesting. I really, really enjoyed that. Well, I guess I'm done with the whole Frasier series, I guess. Well, don't worry. I just finished, since I already did. Let's see, I think I finished this series and Spy Fox. So yeah, I still have to do Plutpug and Jump Sam. I do have a Jump Sam 4. That is, if I can get it to work on number 4 on the computer somehow. But yeah, I'll be doing some more Plutpug. Pretty soon, I hope. Yeah, so I hope you guys... Okay. Thank you, Luther. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you in July for when I do a summer movie in My Scene Goes Hollywood. Till then, goodbye.